Today's video is brought to you by Geology, personalized skincare for men. Stay tuned for a special offer. We've all seen pictures of galaxies, often glorious objects with spectacular colors and shapes. However, because they are static images, it may make you wonder how they rotate. The first obvious thought is that they spin around an axis, perhaps looking something like this as they do so. Would it surprise you to hear that this is totally wrong? For a start, galaxies are not solid objects, but rather made up of millions to trillions of stars. Each star follows their own orbit, although they are often going in the same direction at least. But actually, one of the main reasons a spiral galaxy does not orbit like the first example is that angular momentum would wind the arms up into tighter and tighter spirals. We don't see this, so something else is at play. The leading theory is that these arms are caused by density waves, meaning a galaxy's rotation would in fact look like this. Here, the arms stay in place, or at least move extremely slowly, as stars and gas pass through them. Another theory is that shock waves produced by supernova and stellar winds are the cause of the arms. These theories might not be mutually exclusive, and both processes may be at work here. Density waves are potentially caused by the self-gravity of stars as they orbit after they have been perturbed by another force. As stars have a gravitational influence on each other, eventually a pattern forms where their orbits meet around certain areas in the galaxy. Very, very interestingly, density waves are even seen in certain parts of Saturn's rings. Here you have a section of ring that appears like the inside of a tree trunk, but this is not the case. In this region, the ring is influenced by the gravity of small shepherd moons tucked inside the rings. What you are actually looking at is one very tightly wound ring, a bit like an LP record. And just like with a galaxy, this arm stays the same shape, never getting tighter or looser. Within these arms is where the majority of star formation takes place in a spiral galaxy. The gas and dust within a galaxy clump up in these arms too, which is why you often see star-forming nebula dotting the arms. The arms are also brighter, not just because there are more stars here, but also because all the hot, young, bright stars are found in these regions. Because the hottest types of stars are so short-lived, by the time they move away from the arms, a lot of them will have already burned out. Another interesting phenomenon to do with spiral galaxies is something caused by dark matter. In the early universe, when dark matter was more dispersed, stars within galaxies that are dominated by normal matter would orbit a lot slower around the outside of the galaxy than towards the center. However, today, stars are moving a lot faster near the edge of the galaxy thanks to the influence of dark matter. Dark matter is mysterious in that it cannot be seen or observed in any way other than by its gravitational influence. Dark matter seems to have clumped towards the center of galaxies over time, making stars orbit faster than they should around the edge of a galaxy if only gravity from normal matter was accounted for. Other theories also exist about why this may take place, but these would have to change the way we currently understand physics. Anyway, how do we know about this change in the way stars orbit galaxies? Well, of course, we can see back in time when we look at extremely distant objects. Stars within galaxies billions of light years away seem to orbit slower than stars much closer to us, and this effect scales depending on the distance to the galaxy. Of course, though, there are some rule breakers out there. While most galaxies have stars that orbit like this, a few have been spotted that have leading outer arms. One example is NGC 4622, a bizarre galaxy that rotates in the direction the arms are pointing. This was hard to accept at first, until smaller inner arms were also found. This unusual galaxy has probably experienced a merger in its not-too-distant past, which likely caused this phenomenon. Another rule breaker is the Black Eye Galaxy, which has two counter-rotating disks of gas and dust. The inner disk, where you can see all the dust lanes, rotates normally, whereas gas in this outer disk rotates the opposite direction. Interestingly, stars in this outer region do not seem to be orbiting retrograde, meaning it is just the gas that does so. It is believed that gas must be still getting fed into the galaxy from the intergalactic medium, or that this galaxy also merged with another extremely gas-rich galaxy. The last thing I wanted to show you today is the other major category of galaxy, elliptical galaxies. Elliptical galaxies contain stars that are generally much older than those found in spiral galaxies, because the dust lanes in these galaxies have been exhausted, meaning stellar production has all but stopped. In these kind of galaxies, stars are very much independent from each other, following their own rather elliptical orbits. Sometimes galaxies can exhibit characteristics of both types of galaxies. These are known as lenticular galaxies. These galaxies have dust rings which haven't fully been exhausted yet, and they have quite a ghostly appearance. Star formation does appear to be a factor in keeping spiral arms defined, as once the stellar building blocks dry up, we've seen examples of spiral galaxies losing their definition. Perhaps lenticular galaxies are the midway point between spiral galaxies and elliptical galaxies. So there we have it, a look at how galaxies rotate. Now, space science requires a lot of work to get right, and the same can be said for science behind skincare. Geology is a skincare brand aimed at men that uses science to get skincare right just for you. Purchasing it, I found their application process really interesting. They quiz you about what you are looking for from the product and your skin condition so that the formula is personalized for you. As someone that doesn't typically use skincare products, this eased me into the concept. Once the product arrived, I was also really impressed with the tips I was sent via email about how to use it best. So if you are looking to treat your skin, or need help with acne, wrinkles, or other blemishes, I suggest you give this a go. If you use the link in the description and the promo code ASTRUM30, you can get 30% off a 30-day trial set. Thanks for watching and supporting the channel. Be sure to like and subscribe if you want more of this in the future, and comment if you have other space-related questions that need answering. I may pick your question next. A big thanks to my patrons and members too. If you want to support this way, check out the link in the description. All the best, and see you next time.